Ahsoka Episode 5 is pretty good. It's definitely a step down from Episode 4, but it still has the great visuals, good action, and the acting is easily the best yet. Spoilers for Ahsoka Episode 5. So the episode starts with Hera landing on the planet to look for Ahsoka as Sabine. Then we cut to Ahsoka, and she's talking with Anakin, who looks so much better than he did in Episode 4. But yeah, he and Ahsoka talks, he gives her a choice.
Live. Or die.
And they fight. It's a pretty decent fight, though it definitely could have been longer, and had even better choreography, but it's still good. Then we fall into the Clone Wars, and we see a young Ahsoka and Anakin in his Clone Wars look, which, as someone who watched the Clone Wars, I gotta admit, it was pretty awesome to see him in live action. He has a few conversations with Ahsoka throughout all the flashbacks, tell her that, you know, she needs to keep fighting or die. And then Anakin also flashes to Darth Vader a few times as well, which was actually really well done. Ahsoka beats him, she gets resurrected or something, it's not really explained, and Hera rescues her. Then the episode loses its steam quite a bit. They figure out that Sabine went with Baylan and Shin, which means they know where Thrawn is. You'd think they start a panic and try everything to find out where they are, since, you know, they're gonna find Thrawn. But they talk, they walk, they take a few minutes to talk to space whales because the show needs spectacle. It's just weird for the show to have no sense of urgency when the clock is very much ticking. But yeah, they figure out how to follow Sabine, they start following her, and that's it. That's episode 5. I really liked Anakin, you know, Hayden Christensen gives a pretty damn good performance. Ahsoka also gets a lot more to act with in this episode, as she gives a pretty good and emotional performance at times. The lightsaber duel between them was cool, the Clone Wars flashbacks were great, but overall, this episode definitely comes at the cost of the show losing its pacing and overall sense of urgency. It's good, but it's definitely a step down from Episode 4. I'd give it a 75%.